positive impact on our clients who are victims of domestic violence. Thank you for working closely with those of us who provide direct services to victims. The Legal Project provides free and reduced fee civil legal representation, advice, and information for victims of abuse. We provide this representation in order to assist our clients in attaining safety and independence from their abusive partners. Each year, we serve about 1,200 victims of domestic violence in the Capital Region. I wanted to start by saying that we're really very aware of how helpful legislative changes can be for our clients. The last time I had the privilege of speaking at such a public hearing was in 2010 about the divorce reform legislation package. That legislation, since passage, has been incredibly helpful to our clients. The no-fault law has provided many victims with a means to end marriages to abusive spouses without the danger of having to plead details of the abuse. The interim maintenance guidelines have leveled the playing field for economically disadvantaged women in ways nothing since the Child Support Standards Act has done. Clients who have never would never have received interim maintenance are now receiving it, and they're being able to gain back a sense of control over their own destinies through these financial awards. We look forward with great anticipation to the release of the Law Revision Commission's report and to working with you to pass legislation establishing maintenance standards for the final awards. I just very briefly want to touch on some of the specific issues that we feel are important about these pieces of legislation. So many people have given you so much information already. I won't go over any of it, but we feel that the Domestic Violence Survivors Justice Act is a very important act. We don't deal with survivors as defendants. We are civil legal attorneys. However, increasingly we find that we are working with people in civil legal matters who are also defendants. It seems that there is an increasing push by abusers to try to turn the tables on their victims and to be the first one to file criminal charges or to seek orders of protection. And so sometimes we are finding ourselves collaborating with defense attorneys to assist victims that we're representing in civil matters. We all know that there are disproportionate sentencing for women that are convicted of crimes, and we feel that this the Domestic Violence Survivors Justice Act would be very helpful to them. The Legal Project also has a growing immigration program providing pro bono representation to certain immigration matters for victims of domestic violence. This work makes us painfully aware of how important the confidentiality provisions of the Confidentiality of Immigration Status Act would be for these clients. We urge that S-1003 requiring, that law be passed. We also feel that S-1003 requiring courts to make an inquiry about the presence or possession of firearms is incredibly important. As many speakers have said, that is a something that varies from court to court and county to county, and far too many judges don't ask and won't even address this issue. I've been an assistant district attorney, and I can tell you that there are many, many judges, especially in the town courts, who don't bother asking about firearms. In our perspective, all judges who issue orders of protection should be required to ask about firearms every time in every case. So it's not the victim's responsibility to raise that issue. These common sense requirements would provide an additional margin of safety for victims whose intimate partners possess firearms. This is a bill with no budget implications and one that would take almost no time to implement, yet would provide tremendous safety benefits to victims. For much of the same rationale, we also fully support S-7205, which would revoke or suspend the firearms license of those who have an order of protection issued against them. We know the dire risks of firearms in the hands of abusers, and we must do all that we can as a justice system to help reduce the danger facing far too many victims and children. The Legal Project thanks you for the opportunity to present our perspectives on these important pieces of legislation. We look forward to providing you with any information or assistance you may need in passing these bills into law. Our clients' lives will be immensely improved by passage of these bills. Thank you so much.
Thank you.